Hi everyone, this is Maria Takahashi. I have been working for hours on this PowerPoint presentation, which I will present to you. Intergenerational dialogue. Yes, a conversation with your parent counts, but it has to be more than asking them to help out on your homework or pay for your next tuition bills. You remember when your parents say, oh, you have it so easy. You don't have to work so hard. There are so many services that weren't there when I was growing up, etc., etc., etc. And you might be thinking, what? But the pressure to get into college has never been this stressful. Or so you think, because that's what your guidance counselors tell you. The reality is, each person has a story. And in each story, there is a protagonist who's trying to make best out of its own environment. And it's really hard to say if you would have been a better student if you lived in your grandparents' age, or if they would have been able to secure a job in this particular market. So, why bother? You've probably heard words such as sustainable future and going green. This so-called bright and sustainable future is surprisingly a source of debate. And I say surprisingly because, well, who wouldn't want a future to look forward to? The issue here is that I met young people who say, I can't believe we have all this environmental problem. What was the older generation thinking? Are you one of them? I admit, I used to be one of them. I also talked with some longtime engineers and scientists who have been working on making innovative changes. There are a lot of good work that the older generation has done. I talked with a retired FDA scientist who said, so everyone think everything natural is the best. It scares me because some of these processes like pasteurization is there for safety concern. There may be more processed food than we need, but that's for us to sort out. Admit it, some of you wouldn't know what to do without the constant data access on your smartphone. So the older generation is handing off all the goodies and some issues that probably weren't issues when they were growing up. So there's a trade-off. The important part is, if you are a young student ready to make a change for a better world, great. We need more motivated people like you. If you are a professional with knowledge, wisdom, and whatever else you have to provide, we would love to hear from you. How do we get this started? Well, there are a lot of organizations that promote this kind of dialogue. Allow me to make a pitch for a nonprofit called Our Task. We are promoting, you guessed it, intergenerational dialogue. The easiest way is for you to blog or video blog. The greatest perk is that you can be anywhere in this world as long as you have internet access, webcam, and yes, something to say. Preferably, you did a little bit of research. Now, there's also a video production project that's going on. It's a little bit more formal process. We have professional cameras, we do interviews, background research, all the things that come along with basic pre-production. Before I bore you with all of this, I would ask you to check out our website, ourtask.org. Next time, I want to continue this discussion through a movie. So if you are a big fan or a critic of Miyazaki's film, Spirited Away, tune in next week. Here are my two mottos. Learn as you live, act, not complain. This is Maria Takahashi. Until next time, bye.